A few years ago, in a kingdom not very far away, a princess was born to a king and a queen. She was nurtured by her father and mother, and surrounded by loving and adoring grandparents. As she grew, it became obvious to them that she was gifted, radiant, and precocious. She learned to type by age one. She learned sign language and was able to say, in sign language, "I don't know," a term she has never actually verbalized. By age two, she was singing and performing at local arenas.
To the prairies, to the ocean, why before God left America, my home, sweet home.
Very good.
She had a wonderful and loving nanny. She was popular and made friends easily. By age three, she was flying for business. But mostly, she was just adorable. As she grew, her sisters came from far and near. First one, then another, and then finally, another. And they were a family. She and her sisters were blessed by cousins, aunts, and uncles. And cousins, and aunts, and uncles. And that is the story of their perfect fairy tale life. Except it wasn't a fairy tale, and it wasn't perfect. Allison tormented her sisters. They had good days, and they had bad days. And sometimes there were really bad days. The truth is, they were a normal, complicated, messy family. They tried and they failed, and they tried and they succeeded, but they always tried. Okay, I believe that's enough about that side of the merger. In the meantime, in a state far away, a boy was born to a loving family, and he was gifted, and precocious, and adorable as well. And he went to his first Indians game at 5 weeks of age, throwing out the first pitch. He was riding horses by age two. At age three, he was swimming in a very deep lake, spearfishing for food without a life preserver. Wait a second here, where are this child's parents? By age four, he was winning races, breaking bones, and was the first in his neighborhood to pioneer Jane Fonda's aerobics program. He had strange, furry friends too, but mostly, he was just adorable. And his family grew as well, first a sister, then a brother, and they were surrounded by cousins, aunts, and uncles. And as before, things were not perfect. Not every idea worked out. In particular, he seemed to suffer from bad hair days. Some were much worse than others, and... Whoa! I did not see that coming. He may have overreacted just a little, if you ask me. And he grew until one fateful day, this boy and this girl decided to go to space camp. Now they pretended to have an actual interest in science, but everyone knows that space camp is the place where nerds go to find romance. So they met, and it went like this.
We'll be right back.
actually wasn't like that. It was more like this. Until one day, a short 7 years later, the day we had all been hoping for had finally come. The girl's family was so happy that her cousin Jack drank way too much, stole Mike Tyson's tiger, and pulled out one of his front teeth with a pair of pliers. No, wait. That's a different story. They did have a party, though. Oh, what a party. And they took some pictures, because they always take pictures. Now here in this theater, Allison and Kurt, you are surrounded by those who love and care for you most as you head toward your future. And because of them, we are all connected now. Family, or at least in-laws. Wait a second. There is one more thing we have to do. There are a few people we need to thank. We would be remiss, and we are not big on remiss.
Between us can't be broken. I will be here, don't you cry.
Don't you cry when destiny calls you. You must be strong.
You gotta be strong.
It may not be with you, but you gotta hold on.
Show them together,
God, you'll be in my heart.
You'll be in my heart.
Congratulations, Allison and Kurt. May you two adorable people live happily ever after. Now, here's an idea. Let's take a picture.